Well, hi, I'm Pat Pauley. I'm from Rochester, New York. I've got a piece here called Blue Cross, even though it is a white cross. We don't need to discuss that. I started this as a challenge, and I like to challenge myself. I think it's life itself is challenging. So I think challenging yourself to just behave and grow up and be a good adult is a good thing. In my own work, I challenge myself. I challenge myself to write a blog post every day, and I've done it for almost 7 years, every single day. And I realize that I respond to that motivation. So when I was making work, I was using a lot of fabric, and I was thinking about that. And I was thinking about being decisive. So in this piece, I used just 2 1-yard pieces. It's called Take Two, Blue Cross. And I have a whole series of Take Two. Anyway, I've used just 2 pieces of my fabric. It happens to be kind of great fabric. And it's not too obvious that they're different fabric pieces. Anyway, what I wanted to do besides make a quilt just using that is to base a composition going back to the tradition of quilting, which is making the composition, in this case, a 9-patch, but I've used overall, I've used center medallion, I've used broderie purse, I've used all of the language of traditional quilts in making this. And I think the contemporary quilts are an homage to that traditional quilt making. And so this composition drew from that. It's monoprinted, that's the blue and white, and so it's my direct hand print. But it does form itself into a white cross, and that's my piece. Did I say I was from Rochester, New York, home of Susan B. Anthony, who would be proud that women are continuing this tradition? And she did actually make a quilt once or twice in her life. My background is in art. I studied art, so I have a degree in art education, so I'm very comfortable teaching, and I'm comfortable with art and design. And I worked for a number of years in designing exhibitions, so I'm very comfortable in presenting art. To be in Quilt National, it's funny, it's an honor. It is not the be and end all. It's definitely a large part of who I am. But Quilt National, I made a quilt, my very first quilt. I saw an advertisement to enter quilts, and I entered it. So I made it in 81. I entered the quilt in 1983. So I was in Quilt National in 1983. It was a much quieter show. There wasn't as much advertising, and certainly we didn't have the web. So I sent my quilt off. It came back. I continued to make quilts, contemporary quilts. And I was a self-taught artist in fiber art. So I hadn't taken a class for years. But my quilts I continued to make. And so that my very first quilt was in Quilt National. And I'm very pleased. I wasn't in Quilt National again for another 26 years, and I apparently hold the record for the most amount of time between being accepted. I didn't enter every show in between then. I just had other things going on. And but anyway, it's kind of fun. So I've been in Quilt National 5 times, and I feel very comfortable being part of it and saying, yes, I am part of Quilt National. It's a wonderful opportunity, and it's a huge platform for us as fiber artists. All right, this is only 3 minutes, though.
Yes.
Okay. You're really not going to edit these out. Everybody keeps thinking we're going to get edited. We're not getting edited.
Yeah, you're getting edited.
Oh.